a new sound, honey, but it's still rock and roll to me. Hey guys, TK1138 here. You know, I was really thinking a lot of the YouTubers I've watched, one of my favorite things about them is to get to know them, you know, in their vlogs or, you know, their profiles, to really understand, you know, more than just their gear and play style. So, you know, I was like, well, shit, I got free time and I travel a lot for Nerf. I'm going to do a vlog too, because why not? So anyway, today is Saturday, May 27th, and I'm on my way to an NEANC JCC work number 4 Nerf War. Has a whole bunch of letters. But what that is the NEANC is a Northeast Alabama Nerf Club. They are apparently right in my backyard, like less than an hour away. And seeing as I travel like 2.5 hours, man, those were nice motorcycles. But seeing as I travel 2.5 hours for, you know, an SENC war, an hour seemed like no problem. They are a smaller club, kind of new, but, you know, I've got a history of going out to do a lot of wars in random locations. Last year, we did the SENC DTF, which stood for Down to Florida, mission in November to Gainesville, Florida, and that was a great war. I mean, that was the first war footage I posted on my channel, and yeah, I hadn't even really considered doing war footage, but I made a really cool trade. I got a GoPro. I was like, well, let me give this a shot, and it was a lot of fun. And then in March or April, David Sexton from the SCNC, he made the Discord. Him and I did a road trip down to Mobile, Alabama for the SANC, Southern Alabama Nerf Club War. That was a good time. Our friend Aurelio throws a hell of a war, and that was a lot of fun. So I figured if I'm gonna willing to drive 8 hours or 6 hours to go to a Nerf war in another state or in the farthest reach of this state, I figure I could drive an hour out to NEANC and see what these boys are up to. Think too much. I'm sure more than a couple of people are gonna be like, hey, I just saw Drac do one of these about the SCNC to meet Baby Isaac, who is a really cool dude, by the way, Drac and Baby Isaac. But truthfully, I'm trying to find out other stuff to do besides gameplay. I know I started out doing reviews and I kind of moved more to gameplay, and I've kind of been knocking out some reviews here and there. I really wanna get back a little bit more into it. Also, in late August, my wife is having our baby. So I'm actually going to be out of the Nerf Wars for like 2 months, maybe 3. I don't know. It depends. If I'm going to lose some serious husband points for going to a Nerf War later, we'll see. But for at least 2 months, I'm not going to be generating any new gameplay footage. So a couple of months ago, I started putting some games in my baby bank, which sounds weird. But it's just some footage to have some sort of gameplay, some really good games. And it's not that they're bad games, that's why I don't post them right away, but like, for instance, at Austin's birthday, I covered Territories, and I covered Defend the Core. Well, at the very next war, like 2 weeks later, I had a really good Territories and a really good Defend the Core, and it just seemed kind of repetitive, because I really want to kind of branch out, do a little bit more different types of gameplay. So, starting a vlog like this, about, you know, modding projects or, you know, whatever, might be something to do to help get us through those couple of months. So I've never been out to an NEANC war. I remember when the NEANC started, because I had a better acronym for it. So NEANC, Northeast Alabama Nerf Club. Right? Well, I was thinking, you know, why put East in there? If you drop the E, there's so many words available. Like, it could have been the Northeast Alabama Nerf Club, yo. Also known as Nancy. Maybe that's why they didn't like it. Because Scott runs a group. I remember going, hey, Nancy would be a great name. I don't think he liked that. So, anyway, this could be like 2 guys. This could be like 10 guys. Who knows, but I'm looking forward to it. And everybody goes, wow, the SCNC looks so cool and you have such big wars. And it's great. But it's also super, super competitive. And yeah, like when David and I went down to Mobile for the SANC inaugural war, that was a lot of fun because we got to run with gear we don't usually run with, because at an SCNC it'd get chewed up. That's not to say that, like, oh, you have to have a super powerful blaster to be in the, you know, SCNC. That's not it at all. It's just, I'm a competitive person by nature. And so I'm going to gear up, like, I'm going to rate my gear to match who I'm playing against. And if it's five guys, you know, maybe I don't need to run an FDL2 with 16 mags. I'm really hoping today to just have, like, my drop leg on one side and... That's my LiPo charger. Topping off a LiPo while I'm driving, because I bought this really cool car adapter that lets me do that. Super handy when, you know, you gotta charge stuff on the go, but it's really loud. But anyway, yeah, I'm really looking forward to this. I'm gonna actually be running the long shot after putting 2 months and dollars into it. You know, it'd be nice to use it. So I'm gonna use that today, my Strife, my Hammer Shot. I've got the, I think I packed the FDL. I'm not sure, so... We'll wait and see. I can't wait to see what we're getting into. So, unlike a lot of wars, I'm running really, really light. Now, everyone kind of notices my gear is usually kind of heavy, you know, 16 round or 16 magazines and whatnot. Today, all I'm running is my 3 on a drop leg, my Strife as a backup, and a hydro pack, plus my primary blaster. So, this way I'm running minus 12 from where I usually do. So, this is going to be fun. I might have the least amount of ammo here, guys. Do you believe it?
3, 2, 1, go!
Riders on the storm. Laser beams, man. Out of range. Like a dog without a bone, an actor out alone, riders on the storm. There's a killer on the road. His brain is going out the toe. Take a long holiday. Yep. This is the FL. The Steven Foam Launcher V1. Not very effective, nope. Beep. Alright. He's got 4, 3, 2, 1. Nope. It is. Make him understand. The world on you depends, our life will never end. Gotta love your man. Here we go. Okay, so this is a full auto Zeus. How many rounds are in this? 12 rounds. So this is a part cannon, part gun, burp gun. That, yeah. No, I need to stop. Wow, that.
It was fun. It was interesting. Definitely not like SCNC where it's, you know, a lot of tree camping and, you know, tactical movement. This was just literally like a 20 meter by 20 meter square of grass. So it was very, it reminded me of like speedball, but with zero cover. But it wasn't bad, you know, a couple fun games, and getting to use my Strife was great because it's really No, I don't get a chance to run it. I've had the stripe for like several wars now, and I never pull it at SCNC because I've never needed to. But yeah, it's actually really good. It's a shame I don't use it more, but I mean, really, with the stripe compared to the FDL2, it's day and night.
On my way back home from the NEANC, I was out there for about 3 hours. Fun time, it was four of us, and you know, it was a very different type of game, but I really, you know, I like the vibe there. Scott's doing really great. Jansen, Nathan, yeah, that's him. And it was a good time. I think, you know, the beauty is they're really close to a big college that if they did a little advertising on the college campus, I imagine they could get themselves out, you know, a couple more members. It looks like the beginning of a really strong club, and I definitely hope to see more of the NEANC posting about events. You know, again, especially being in my own backyard. Don't get me wrong, I love the SCNC. I am proud to be in the SCNC. But, you know, like, when I go to an SCNC war, I am getting up at 5 in the morning. I'm loading my car. I'm driving 2 hours. I'm getting there. I'm setting up tents and blasters and loading mags and mags and mags and mags and playing for 10 or more hours and then packing out. And basically, it takes the whole day, which I have no problem. Are you kidding? A whole day of nerfing sounds great. But, you know, it does, my wife has been super awesome letting me do that, and I definitely don't want to, like, take too much of an advantage of this, but this was great. You know, I nerfed for 3 hours, it's an hour there, hour back, so it's a half day event, and I had a lot of fun. So thank you guys for having me, and I hope to do this again. So, yeah, this was the TK1138 mission vlog, the first one, hopefully not the last one. You know, these are going to be really easy to edit because it's just blocks of me monologuing. But, yeah. So, thanks very much for watching, I guess. And I'll see you guys next time. I should have another gameplay video up later on this week. And I will also be announcing the winner of the 501st subscriber giveaway for the drop leg molly platform with 4 mag holders, 4 mags, and 100 Ekine waffle darts. And that will be closing Thursday, June 1st. And I'll be announcing it at the end of the gameplay video on Friday, June 2nd. So, anyway, guys, this has been TK1138. Nerf well, my friends. Y'all think you think too much. Don't you know about the new fashion hoodie? All you need to look sad.